Welcome to Drawfee, where we take your dumb ideas
and make even dumber drawings.
I'm Jacob.
I'm Nathan.
I'm Karina.
And I'm Julia.
And today we're merging with our dark selves.
Self-cessed?
Not self-cessed, but something even more sinister. Like, what if Disney heroes merged with their respective villains? This one was brought to us from the Drawfee Patreon Discord user Corvar, and I thought it was just a delightful topic.
Is that something that happens in Kingdom Hearts? It should be.
Probably.
Could be.
I know Buzz Lightyear becomes evil.
He does?
Evil Buzz?
Yeah, he falls prey to the darkness.
Oh my god. Oh.
What a wild series.
But we didn't fall prey to the darkness. Instead, we did some really good drawings, and they're speed draws, and we're going to show them to you now and talk about them.
Falling with style, prey to the darkness.
Yes, sure. Nathan. Speaking of yes, Nathan. Yes, Nathan is going first.
Yeah. Sorry, that was evil Nathan who said that.
Well, that answers my question.
Yeah. I've merged.
Nathan, tell us about what you chose to do.
I merged Mowgli with Shere Khan.
Oh,
all right.
The Jungle Book.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's fun.
The Jungle Book is my favorite Disney movie.
Aw.
So.
I thought it was Jurassic Park.
Jurassic Park is my second favorite Disney movie.
Well, should we just jump right into it?
Yeah, let's get in there.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go!
I realize I haven't watched The Jungle Book in a while, but the parts I remember of it, It's just like a fun time, beautiful painted backgrounds.
Yeah, it's a beautiful movie.
Bunch of animals, a bunch of real fun slapstick bits. So started off just doing a little sketches of my two characters.
Little study.
Doing a little study.
These are great studies. Shit.
Yeah. Thank you. I drew for people. Patrons at the draw class tier might remember I drew Shere Khan on one of my draw class streams because I really like the design. Yeah. So I realized that Mowgli is sort of a idiot, belligerent kid, and Shere Khan is strong and has a singular focus on a goal.
Yeah.
So when you combine them, you get any shonen protagonist.
Oh, yeah, true.
Yeah, that seems right.
Head empty, all power.
So I just made him sort of a mischievous cat boy. I figure, you know, Shere Khan, he's not like evil. He's just rightly suspicious of people and doesn't want them in his jungle.
Yeah, I get that.
So what if he was part person and also had some of Mowgli's energy, and so that's sort of where I went. He's just sort of like a little meow meow boy.
He is. Wow.
And Nathan, you can watch me struggle with these legs. I still don't ever know how to draw legs, where to put them, what to do with them, but I was pretty because like, again, Mowgli is so gangly and little, and Shere Khan's like real thick, and so I had to split the
Ooh.
Difference.
Ooh.
Good poses.
Character sheet?
Yeah, well, I wanted to do a character sheet because I didn't want to do a background. But
yeah.
then I ended up with just the two.
You didn't want to do a full painted background of a jungle?
I did. Well, here's the thing. Is I kind of
why. Yeah.
I wish I had given myself enough time to do that, because you'll see at the end of this, I do just sort of struggle with what to do with the background, because I got tired after doing these two poses. And was like, I'm not going to fill up the page with poses. And I also kind of like the duality of like happy tiger boy and more sort of brooding.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's cool.
His little pout.
I love the stretch.
Yeah, don't keep it. But
I know.
Boo this man.
You may notice I am working in Clip Studio, and so I'm finally using that good pen.
It's the good pen.
There it is.
Oh, I love to see it.
What a pleasure to ink with this pen.
Yeah, these inks look great.
I love, because we've all used it. We all have it.
We all have
them. But it looks so different from person to person. So I think that's wonderful how versatile it is. So yay, getting to see Nathan use it.
And it's also, it's just impossible to do bad inks with it. No matter how you're using it, there's no wrong way to use the good pen.
Yeah.
It's just a good pen. The pen is good.
Yeah. Yeah, these look great.
This looks legit. Thank you.
Got such nice line weight to them.
Yeah, I really like this character. I don't know what his name would be. The only thing that I was...
Shmogly
is what I was... Which feels disrespectful.
It does.
But it is fun to say. So if people have...
Little Meow Meow.
He is Little Meow Meow also. I titled my document Man Cub because that's what they call him in the movie.
Aww.
And now he's even more of a man cub because he's raised by wolves in the film.
Yeah, sure.
And then just drawn some stripies. Doing some, again, like, I love the Shere Khan design. It just looks so smooth and sleek and nice, and just the way he moves and everything. It's just a great cartoonification of an animal. The people who worked on that clearly looked at tigers for a long time and made a real good-looking cartoon one.
Captures that sleek but powerful energy.
Yeah. And now we're just... I basically just color-picked from screenshots from the movie and lightened it up slightly. Because Shere Khan's actually pretty dark. That's basically it. If people want to draw more like anime protagonist sort of vibes for this guy, I would love to see that. That's a call for fan art.
There it is.
There it is.
Yeah, we got to remember to all call for fan art today. Okay.
Yeah, I was real happy with how this design turned
this
out.
This looks
though.
So good.
Yeah, I love these poses.
It looks great.
It looks like so official.
It does. Yeah, I would believe
that. That's what I mean.
I'll take it.
I didn't mean that in like how you say sarcastically or in anything.
No. These speed draws are for sincere compliments only.
Yeah,
and I love that about them.
Like, this is so solid.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's got the animation cell like vibe to it.
Yeah, I mean, it's great to just work from reference from Disney because they do good character designs. Two well-designed characters combined make another well-designed character. And here we go with my background struggles.
I'm just surprised you didn't immediately go for large geometric shape in the background.
Oh, it's coming.
Just you wait.
Because that would be my solution.
Yeah.
It is. It just took me a while.
He got cocky.
maybe this once I won't do it that way. They all look kind of fine in retrospect, but...
Yeah, I think you could have got away with any of them, really.
I did like the grass one.
Yeah, I like that one too. Oh,
okay, you brought
back.
It back. You brought it back.
Yeah, there are. I ended up just going with some grass and some circles.
These are his Pokemon sprites.
Yeah, this is. I choose you.
Yeah, and in his back sprite, he is looking at you.
I was about
scowling.
To say. Imagine taking out your Pokemon and it looks at you
with disdain.
Yeah. He's doing a Julia's Monferno sort of look over the shoulder,
accusing you, the trainer, of wrongdoing.
But yeah, that's mine. I was pretty happy with
so
this one.
Good.
Yeah, it looks so cool.
Yeah,
I really
love
it.
You should be happy with this one. It's great.
I love the animal to creature. It's a furry pipeline. You're experiencing Nathan.
He's spiraling down the pipe.
Good for him.
My only drawing creatures arc has now taken a turn into furry territory, but you know,
we love to see it.
I enjoyed it.
Not bad territory.
And yeah, please draw fan art of this of this tiger boy.
You heard Nathan.
Please.
Well, I'm up next.
Yes.
Woo.
And for mine, I chose to do Aladdin and Jafar.
Nice.
Ooh.
And much like Nathan, I'm about to just get right into it. So here we go.
Alrighty.
3, 2, 1, go. So you're about to see the pose struggle happen for a while here.
We all know it.
I knew I wanted sort of a like a cocky, confident pose, and I wanted the lamp to be like dangling off a finger.
Ooh, off of one finger. Fun. I like that.
Because my concept for this one was Aladdin, one of his character traits that's positive in the movie but could be negative is his like sort of cocky demeanor.
Yeah.
He's got kind of a cocky swagger to him. And, you know, what if once he saved the day, he thought maybe a little too highly of himself and reneged on his agreement to free the genie and decided to keep the power for himself. He's like, well, I deserve it. You know, I saved the day. I did all the work. Why don't I keep the power? So and then he, you know, kind of falls prey to it's different than Jafar, who just wanted to be like the strongest. Aladdin tricks himself into thinking he deserves it.
Okay.
So this is partially the pose I end up going with, but it has a moment where I truly figure it out. But the hand and arm stay, and I'm like, something's not right. Like, I keep, like, moving things and rotating things.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what can I do to fix this? It's, like, got a weird vibe to it. So you'll see shortly here, I take that whole thing, and I move it that way, and then I'm like, oh, there we go.
Action,
action, action.
Yeah. Had to angle the body the opposite way from the arm, and then it's got a cool action vibe to it.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that, like, he's always doing them jumps and moving around. Got that movement.
Yeah, he has, like, a fluid moving sort of character.
He, like, surfs down the snake at
he
that
surfs
part.
Down the snake.
Sometimes you gotta, sometimes you just do that. You gotta surf down the snake.
Try to surf the snake in your own life.
When there's a big snake, try surfing it.
Yeah, try surfing it.
Oh my god, he has a goatee.
I end up giving him some, like, that dude from the Hunger Games.
Oh, yeah.
Beard.
Oh.
You sure do.
Because that's cool. I had to get some sort of, like, Jafar-esque beard action in there.
Yeah.
And then, of course, when a character turns evil, they push their hair back.
Yeah.
That's just anime rules.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the hair is pushed back, and then, you know, a little touch there. He's got the three fingers up for the wishes.
Oh! That's design.
Yeah, that's design.
He's thinking.
Then I had to figure out what the lamp actually looks like.
Reference, love reference.
Get that in there. And his outfit is like an extrapolation of his Prince Ali prince outfit. With more of a Jafar robe angle to it.
Yeah.
Good for him.
I'm not using the good pen. I'm using the Ciro.
Brush. Why are we on the same character arc?
I don't know. I've just really been liking Ciro lately. I've been vibing same. With that one. Ooh.
I gotta get that one.
I love those little swooshes around the shoulders, whatever those are.
Who knows?
just whatever, like, they are truly.
It really I don't know, because there's so much energy in this pose, it gives it even more action.
Well, thank you. I was nice pleased with it as well. I was happy with how quickly I got the swooshes.
Yeah.
I thought it was gonna take me a good few attempts.
First attempt swoosh.
Yeah. It's not easy to do.
I have a question, Jacob.
Yeah.
Did you ever see any of the Aladdin sequel movies?
Were you about to ask about Aladdin's dad?
Yeah. Because
it does kind of look like Aladdin's dad.
That was why I was just on my phone, so I could Google Aladdin's dad to cross-reference.
You mean the Prince of Thieves?
Yeah.
I've never seen Aladdin's dad, so clearly I just have...
Jacob's the only one who's never seen him, and yet he nailed it.
Yeah.
I have the same design sensibilities as Disney character designers, just naturally.
Yeah, good for him.
He only kind of looks like Aladdin's...
No.
But you nailed it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's really good.
It's really good.
Yeah, I can kind of see a vibe now that I'm looking at him for sure. Then colors were color picked. I did Aladdin's robes and then the pinkish reds from Jafar's robes.
Yeah.
And then I paused for a long time.
To admire your good work.
Yeah, like, hmm.
Oh, I was looking for Cave of Wonders reference because I wanted to I wanted to color pick the blues from that for the background.
Oh, I love the way the smoke makes this composition. It's really nice.
And of course,
rim lighting.
Orange rim lighting.
Shit.
Yeah.
An implied Cave of Wonders back there that I didn't draw.
He's no longer the diamond in the rough. He's just rough.
He's just rough now.
Shit.
But he thinks he's a diamond.
Oh, shit.
He's no longer a street rat. He's just a rat.
Yes.
Yeah, I imagine this is like sort of POV. Aladdin has betrayed you. Like, you're in the desert with him and he has betrayed you for more power.
He just kicked you down a hole.
Yeah. And you're like looking up at him being like, how could this have happened?
To me, I made my mistakes.
Yeah, thank exactly. You, Nathan. There's nowhere to run, but life goes on.
Man, I'm fading away. Jacob, this is really good.
Thank you. I'm adding a little glow now.
The soft glow. Yeah,
the soft
dude.
Glow.
I love it.
And then we're going to crop it and we're going to add some more shadows and darken the background a bit so he pops. Get a little blur on the smoke. I end up not using the filter, but instead using the blur tool, which I then manually go in and like add the blur where I want it.
Oh, yeah.
So it's like differently blurry at different parts. I'm thinking about fading it, but I decide not to. And then I think the last thing I do is just add a little bit of glow to his face, just to brighten up the face zone a bit and draw attention to it.
Yeah.
Ooh.
That's nice.
And then that's it.
I'm going to steal Karina's compliment that she gave me and say this looks professional as hell.
Thank you. I ended up being really happy with it, too.
Y'all, are we professional artists?
We might be. It looks like it sometimes.
Oh, my God.
Not all the time, but sometimes.
This is awesome.
Yeah, this rules.
Thank you. Thank you. This is Aladdin Nafar.
Jaladin.
Nice.
Nice.
It's a gelatinous flatulence.
Jaladin. Bro, I had the worst Jaladin last night.
Awful.
Who would say such a thing?
I'm done.
Jacob Drawfee. And evil Jacob combined would say such a thing.
Yep. Karina, you're up next. Who'd you do?
I wanted to make my subject matter relatively easy and cater to my interests. So naturally, I did Hercules and Hades.
Ooh, yeah.
You want to just start on all in on it?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1, go.
So I just thought like it would just be a fun design. It'd be a fun design. It'd be right up my alley. Just draw big strong boy, but make him kind of spooky and evil.
You never do that.
Yeah, I've never done that before. This is new territory for me. Nah, this is another one of those speed draws where I was like, yeah, I gotta do this. But I just thought it'd be really fun and I could mash up their outfits.
Oh
and
my
like,
God.
Yeah. So, and I did this all using the Ciro brush, like Jacob.
Ciro.
And then I wanted to do the minions, not the minions from the movie Minions, but the little guys, the little demon.
Pegasus and
But for Phineas him, it would be Phineas and Ferb.
Yeah.
Yeah, Danny DeVito and the horse. I don't remember their names. But yeah.
Pain and Panic?
Yes.
Yeah, there we go.
Thanks, nerd. Yeah. But Yeah, so I largely kept him looking like Hercules, but I gave him more of Hades' outfit and the fire, of course, because that's so fucking cool. And I wanted to give him little heeled sandals because every Disney villain's like a little slutty. So this is just a sluttier Hercules. And I love that for him. The horse is a demon now. Danny DeVito. He's roughly the same. I wanted to give them like fire thing and then I changed it to smoke and I started inking with the good pen, but I'm on some like incredibly thin, sketchy line art shit right now. So I just made the zero brush even smaller and used that for my line art. So that's
it looks good.
What it is.
Yeah.
So
it's so versatile, just like the good pen.
Yeah, it turns out that once you just find a way you like to use a certain brush, like you can just make it look good however you like to use it. But yeah, so I wanted to do, there's so much like good fabric in, especially in Hades' design. So yeah. I wanted to do those. And I did kind of like change up his outfit a little. So instead of going or as a neckline, that part goes as like, how you say, it goes, it's looser and you can see more of his titty. And it's also see-through because I thought that looked nice. But
yes, I won't say I'm in love with this, but I will say I'm in love with this.
It's a reference.
It's a reference. That's the song they sing.
Good one, Meg, Julia.
You're so sexy.
Anyway, please talk over me redrawing the foot an unfortunate amount of times because I couldn't figure out the shape of it.
That's me. Yeah. I did that.
Oh, but it just keeps going. It just keeps going is the thing. So, please distract. Please distract from my struggle. Yeah, she's still at like, it.
I think it was already like good enough. I think you.
Yeah.
You
got
well, I redid
head.
It. I was going to turn it out, but the leg is already turned so that the knee is facing forward. So I was stuck doing it in this position. And it just took me many tries. But I got there. I got there.
Yeah. You got there. Congrats.
I got there and it looked better.
You went the distance?
Yeah, and then I wanted to give him, because Hades has the really long robes and they're all like foofy at the end. Like, I was looking at, I think, a Kingdom Hearts render of him as my reference. So I did want to like have it doing those smoky whooshies, but still showing leg, because you gotta.
Yeah, of course.
Of course.
Hercules got to get them gams out.
Yeah, I want to see him. And then I just like gave him his shield and then it was like too late to back out of that decision too. But I didn't give him his sword because fuck that. I'm over it. Anyway, we went Hades color scheme. I liked it.
Correct choice. Yeah.
He's just the better character. Most Disney villains are.
I love these thin lines that you're doing with the zero. You really set your zero to zero.
Oh my God, we're on a roll today.
Just
shit.
Like that.
Just oh my like God. That.
This character is hot, and that's a gospel truth.
Anyway, here's me struggling more with lines. The problem with thin line art is that it's harder to like connect the swoopy lines. So yeah. I keep like being like, God damn it, dumb. And then here's this guy. I gotta be real. He was the least of my worries. Didn't even draw his little hooves. And then since they were all behind him, I just only filled in what was sticking out. Fuck that.
Fair.
And then, yeah, and then I made them the little pain and torture, whatever their names are.
Panic.
Yes. And, yeah, so then I had to go in and clean it up because that's the other thing with soft line art that's very thin is that autofill can only do so much. So I did a little cleaning and then I wanted to add some gradation to like, because that's like smoke and then he has his fire and the horse is also smoke naturally. And then I did just shading for my own amusement.
Shading good.
Yeah.
Shading look good.
Thank you.
Yeah. I like, Karina, that we took similar tacks of just sort of taking the base design of the hero character and reskinning them with the villain.
Yeah. I think this is a better design than the original Hercules. I'm going to say it.
Yeah.
And then I did the thing where I used a blur tool to soften some of the shadows while keeping other edges hard, because that's a nice little trick.
Yeah, and it always looks nice. And just
have him doing some goddamn fire, because, yeah.
That's what he do.
That's what he do, I think.
Ooh, nice glow.
Thank you. But yeah, and then I just didn't even bother with a background.
Yeah. He's in hell.
He's in hell, baby.
The background is a big, scary horse.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is so cool, Karina. I love this design.
Yeah, this rules.
Thank you. This was another one where I like where it landed. This is what Hercules should have looked like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If he was a bad guy.
Duh.
Duh. But yeah, amazing work. I want to play this Kingdom Hearts game.
Yeah, put him in Kingdom Hearts. You have my permission, Michael Mouse.
All right, we got one more, and that's a Julia.
That's Ooh. Me.
Who you did?
I did one of my favorite Disney movies, and it's going to be a surprising pick. It's Sleeping
Jurassic
Beauty.
Park?
Oh. Star Wars. No, I did Sleeping Beauty. I combined Aurora and Maleficent.
Nice.
Ooh, oh, fun. Yeah.
Yeah.
Should we jump into it?
Yes.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, go.
Hooray. So what I wanted to do was a sort of illuminated manuscript sort of feeling piece without having to draw vines on vines on vines on vines. Yeah. As illuminated manuscripts do.
Of course.
So a sort of shortcutted version of that is what Gustav Klimt attempted to do. So I'm actually going to reference a sort of like Gustav Klimt sort of piece, style piece.
So you reference like a legendary artist.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Instead of Kingdom Hearts.
Yeah, we referenced Kingdom Hearts.
But I think the thing that I like the most about Sleeping Beauty is the style. The backgrounds are beautiful. I just love the medieval setting. All the characters are fantastic. I was watching a behind the scenes of Sleeping Beauty and how they made it before I did this piece, just to see some design choices they made and things like that. And it was so wildly expensive to make Sleeping Beauty that after the movie, they were like, we can't. We gotta cut back.
We can never do this again.
We can never do this again.
Damn, y'all live like this. It's all of the glass planes.
Yeah. It's like these giant paintings that they used for the backgrounds that like referenced medieval illuminated manuscripts. And they were like,
Disney walks into the warehouse. Yeah. Damn.
Damn, what are you up to? What's happening?
We spent how much?
What? So I wanted to make sort of like a Aurora gone evil sort of dealio.
Aurora Borealis.
Yep.
There it is.
So where she kind of becomes like an evil dragon queen.
Yeah.
Good for her.
And since she lived basically her entire life only knowing 3 fairy godmothers.
Right.
I wanted her to be like kind of cold and like angry that she was locked up for so long, basically, and like kept away from people and all these things. Because here's the thing about Sleeping Beauty. The king's like, my daughter at some point in the future is going to like prick her finger on a loom. That means that I'm going to get rid of all looms right now until my daughter is of the age where she was going to get her finger pricked.
Yeah, that was Maleficent really fucked over all sewers.
Everyone. But like, all you had to do was wait a while and then be like, listen, I'm going to put these in a warehouse and then I'm going to lock it up.
Because she literally says the birthday, right? Like,
yeah.
When she's going to do. Yeah, she gives all the information. He's just like, now, right now, get her out.
Yeah.
Send her to the woods. Get rid of all the looms. Completely yeah, destroy the textile industry in my kingdom.
I'm going to make this everyone else's problem, too. Yeah. I got to deal with it.
But yeah, I wanted to make her like a beautiful but cold queen.
Yeah.
Who just hates everyone for how her life has turned out.
It makes sense.
Yeah.
Valid.
So a lot of references to that border is one that's a reference from an actual illuminated manuscript. I just exaggerated it, so it looks a little more thorny.
You just freehanded those spikes. That was incredible.
I did. It was
they're so nice and uniform. That's
thank
incredible.
You. I had a lot of fun making those.
Are you good penning?
Maybe.
Are you aware of which?
She's on Ciro.
Well,
see
you
it.
Were doing different ones. Now
yeah.
You're on Ciro.
No, that's a different one. That's one. I don't know what that one's called.
That's a different kind of pen.
That's a different pen.
Nice. I was just curious.
Yeah,
that's cool. I don't care.
I literally don't know. I couldn't tell you. I just kind of was. I'm still really new to Clip Studio. I don't really ever use it. So I just was kind of like going into the pens that I have slowly collected and like doing like a test swipe to see
yeah.
how it works and being like, oh, this will have a good look, like a effect.
Yeah.
For this?
Hell yeah.
That's how you do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I was just curious. Don't mind me.
No, it's fine.
Ooh.
yeah. So I'm just, I'm trying to keep the color simple because Klimt usually just did kind of like washes in a lot of his like illustrated pieces that weren't like the big gold foil ones that everyone knows.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's, you know, and I'm trying to keep that illuminated manuscript feel where it's
right.
a little more simple. Here's me not knowing what colors I wanted for anything until I got to it.
Hey.
You really nailed the I haven't seen Sleeping Beauty in so long and immediately just got like flashbacks of the dragon fight with that the flames and like that green and purple.
Yeah, that fight's
the
fun.
The shapes are so good, Julia.
Thank you.
Aurora should have done this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, this is better.
Instead, Aurora does basically nothing.
Yeah.
Aurora is literally... So I say that Sleeping Beauty is my favorite, and it's not because of her. She's basically born, and two fairy godmothers are like, you're going to be beautiful, you're going to be talented. And then Maleficent's like, and when you turn 16 or whatever, you're going to die. And then the third fairy godmother comes in and goes, well, maybe not die, you just sleep until some guy who loves you a lot will kiss you awake.
That's as best as I can do.
That's as best as I can do.
Gonna make you a deal.
It's a strong curse that she did, but I can get
yeah.
if you,
kisses is the magics.
You gotta be asleep while you get kissed, but you know.
I know it's a little weird, but trust
it's
me.
It's pretty weird, but it's the alternative is you die, so.
But she's
the best I can do.
She's literally born and just like given the easiest life, and she's royalty, so you know, she just got the easiest life, and then she truly did nothing but sing nicely, and that was a gift that someone else bestowed on her. But she's beautiful.
Mwah.
And she sleeps. She's got good work-life balance.
Good for her.
Imagine only being known for the one time you slept.
It was a big sleep.
It was a big sleep that put everyone else to sleep. Anyway, here she is.
So pretty.
Yeah, this is so cool.
So designy, so shapey. I love it.
Thank you. Yeah. It's a lot simpler than what you guys were doing, but I wanted to stay designy.
That's the vibe.
Yeah, sometimes the simplicity is the point. That's a choice.
To me, the background is not simpler.
yeah, that's true.
Fair.
Yeah, this rules. Great job, Julia.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, this was a really fun challenge.
Yeah.
I really liked all of the drawings we came up with.
I think what we learned today is that more heroes should be evil.
Yeah.
Yeah.
More evil heroes, please.
Disney.
Or at least slutty. Please, or at Disney. Least, yeah,
if you can't make them evil, at least make them slutty.
You owe us that much. Disney.
Disney. Preferably both, but I'll take one.
Yeah.
But yeah, this was a great challenge. Here's all our beautiful drawings looking at you.
There they are.
Menacingly.
Menacingly, as we get our wonderful patron scroll.
There they are.
Yeah.
Our beautiful wow. patrons who we love so dearly, and you could be one of them. You could be mm-hmm. among them yep. if you join our yeah. Patreon.
And then we'll love you too.
We'll love you too. But even if you can't afford to do that, you can afford to click like and subscribe. And you can afford to watch us on Twitch. That's free, baby.
That's free.
And if you got a little quiche burning a hole in your pocket, go to our merch store and see what we got
oh, yeah.
over there.
Yeah.
Yeah. We got the spinning wheels back so we can make clothing again.
Yeah, we got our looms.
Finally.
Looms in order.
Oh, what a relief.
Thanks for watching, everybody. We are sorry.
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 Sorry.